Hello to all of my viewers, and I welcome you to the brand new and fresh episode of Match Point, in which we will discuss the Pakistan and the New Zealand tour of Pakistan. I mean in their alternate home, Sharjah, Dubai and Abu Dhabi. And also we will discuss what Indian team is doing up, and also moreover we will tell you about the Zimbabwe versus Bangladesh. What happened next when Zimbabwe meets Bangladesh? But first of all, as usual, the headlines. And the major headline, the first headline: Pakistan, after clean sweeping Australia, now clean sweep Black Caps. New Zealand has been smashed in the Pakistan's alternate home 3-0, and this was the Pakistan's 11th consecutive successive series win in the T20s, which is so far, by far, it is the longest winning sequel ever in the history of T20 cricket since it has been originated. Wow! And we just welcome this bounty wins from the Team Pakistan, which are putting them back in the business after they lose Asia Cup by a margin. Although the different formats, but Pakistan is gaining rhythm by the virtue of these T20s. So second headline, which is also regarding the Pakistan team, but regarding the Pakistan Super League. So what's the news, Pakistan? Sunil Narine and Umar Akmal, who were playing in the Lahore Qalandars for the two seasons, and Sunil Narine, with whom I have told you, the only bowler in the history of T20 cricket to bowl the maiden super over. Sunil Narine, who has made them victorious in a one very important match in the last PSL, which was the PSL 3 in Dubai, he is no more in the Lahore Qalandars. So, what up next? Umar Akmal and Sunil Narine has been traded with Quetta Gladiators. So, let's see what's gonna become the fate of Quetta Gladiators, and can this trade, or the trade of the players, can switch the condition and the future of Lahore Qalandars, and Rana Saab Lahore Qalandars can make the wheel turn in the PSL 4 or not. We have to see. Rahat Ali and Hassan Khan, they are moving from Quetta Gladiators into the Lahore Qalandars, and in the place the trading has been for the Sunil Narine and Umar Akmal. So let's see how this switch will work in the PSL 4. So, but this deal means we will see Lahore taking Quetta's first round platinum pick. This is something very important I want to tell you. And Quetta getting Lahore's silver round pick in the second round. So first pick means that Lahore Qalandars getting the first pick in the PSL 4 means that most likely we are going to see AB de Villiers in Lahore Qalandars. Because when Lahore will go for the first pick, 99% I'm sure that AB de Villiers is gonna come to the Lahore Qalandars, and who knows, he could have been the one who will switch the Brendan McCullum as a skipper and the new skipper, upcoming skipper of Lahore Qalandars. So let's see if AB de Villiers comes, the AB phenomena, which is the master blaster phenomena, can it switch the fate of the Lahore Qalandars? Because Brendan McCullum, the most successful man in the history of New Zealanders, and the man who made the consecutive appearances in the finals, and who pushed New Zealand team into the grand finale of the last World Cup, couldn't change the fate of Lahore Qalandars. But AB de Villiers coming into the Lahore Qalandars means something still can happen, because this is a single one-man show as we are seeing in the South Africa. So moving towards my next news is regarding the Azhar Ali. Azhar Ali, as I told you last time, has taken the partial retirement. He will still be playing the test cricket, but he has been occasionally asked what is the most memorable moment in your life. So Azhar Ali telling once again that the most memorable and cherishable moment of his life is the victory in the Champions Trophy Grand Finale versus India in the Oval back in 2017, when Sir Faraz Ahmed's Pakistan picked the Champions Trophy for the record for the third time after the Misbahul Haq's and Moin Khan's attempt long time back. So Champions Trophy, Pakistan won the Champions Trophy by the virtue of Sir Faraz Ahmed's brand new 11. So Azhar Ali still says that he cherished the memory for his lifetime. So next news is regarding the Salman Butt. Salman Butt, one of the tainted Pakistan's cricketers, who along with Mohammad Asif and Mohammad Amir, he was abandoned to play cricket back in 2010 after he was involved in a match fixing. Now, as all of you know, that they are out of that scenario and currently playing the domestic cricket. Amir has joined Pakistan team about 2 years back now, but the other tainted cricketers yet to come back in the Pakistan team, and they are currently fighting for the place in the Pakistan's 11. Salman Butt, in spite of scoring lot of runs in the domestic circuit, still unable to make a place back in the Pakistan squad. So Salman Butt is saying that Najam Sethi, since Najam Sethi was in the Pakistan cricket board, he never wanted him back in the Pakistan team. Salman Butt says that he was the visible stopper for the Salman Butt, and he was letting franchise stay away from me when lot of franchises were trying to contact me for the PSL 4, PSL 3 availability, but Najam Sethi was not willing, and it was his pressure that all the franchises were away from me. So PSL 4 is coming, let's see what happens next. As Salman Butt was saying, Imran Khan, and the Prime Minister of Pakistan and the only World Cup winning captain of the Pakistan, is very happy, absolutely happy after the 11th consecutive series win, and he says Sir Faraz captaincy and the Pakistan team is grooming under his captaincy, and he said congratulations to the Pakistan team, and he is said that he is a well-wisher of the team Pakistan, and he said that he hopes that Pakistan team will perform same in the test matches and in the ODI under the captaincy of Sir Faraz Ahmed. Pakistan last 11 T20 series, as I told you in the beginning in my headline, that all ended into the win. Wow, take a bow. And then now something regarding the Pakistan domestic cricket. Qaid Azam One Day Cup was getting rhythm in Pakistan, and finally Habib Bank Limited HBL winning that Qaid Azam trophy and got rupees 1 million as a result of that win. Umar Gul was the skipper who lifted the trophy and received it from Ehsan Mani. Runners up was Wapda, who got 0.5 million rupees, and the best batsman in this Qaid Azam Cup was Salman Butt from Wapda. 559 runs, he got rupees 1 lakh, and that's why he is eager to come to the Pakistan Super League. The best bowler remained the Muhammad Irfan Jr. in that. He belonged from Pakistan Television PTV with 20 wickets and he got rupees 1 lakh. And best wicket keeper was Waqar Hussain from Multan. 16 catches and 1 stumping. He also got the check of 1 lakh rupees. Going now to the next news, the T20 which has been recently finished with the New Zealand, this series, Waqas Masood made a debut and the new cap was given from Azhar Mahmood, team bowling coach, to Waqas. Waqas makes the international debut. Only a few weeks ago he was playing with the Delft and Dobcross CC and he was not knowing that he will be soon selected to his dream and wearing the green Pakistan cap. But what upcoming next for the Waqas? Get ready, this will come at the end of the match point and of course that will be the killer factor. Mohsin Khan, the new assignment has been given to the Mohsin Khan along with a mighty giant Wasim Akram. Mohsin Khan says when the committee has a meeting and Salman Butt is mentioned, I will support that. If Salman Butt is coming under consideration, he will support Salman Butt because why? Amir has been included. If Amir has been included, Salman Butt should have been given opportunity. If Salman has been abandoned, then Mohammad Amir should never would have given the chance. Still remember that Mohsin Khan is one of the few who were reluctant to have Amir back in the squad. And he was saying that these cricketers who are playing like this or who are doing the business like this for the name of the flag, Pakistan flag, they should be banned for the lifetime. But now after seeing the future of Mohammad Amir, he says, why not? If he's playing, Salman Butt should have been, it should have been the justice and Salman Butt should have been given the chance to come back in the Pakistan cricket team. Pakistan fast bowler Usman Khan Shinwari has been signed by the Big Bash League BBL. So in the BBL, he will be playing for the Melbourne Renegades, from where once the Shane Warne was playing, the mighty Shane Warne. And also we met this summer when with Ben McDermott, Ben was playing some magical innings from Melbourne Renegades. So Usman Shinwari will be the part of the BBL to play the first 7 games for the upcoming BBL. He has shown his availability after getting signed from the PCB. The last news from the headline, the Adidas, the big company, the sports company, have signed Hassan Ali. Very good news for the Hassan Ali after having Kohli and the big names in the market. Now Hassan Ali will be the part of the Adidas and will be promoting around the world this very brand. They have been impressed by the vibrant way how this youngster from the Pakistan is performing after the Champions Trophy grand finale. And they are very happy to have this brand on the name of Hassan Ali, and Hassan Ali got the privilege of becoming the part of this big mega brand which Virat Kohli and lot of other huge tennis stars, they are the part. We go for the trivia factor before going to the break. So I will remind you of the one match which was played back in the October 1989. About how many years? About 30 years, nearly 30 years back. And you will be remembering the grand finale of the Nehru Cup. Team Pakistan and Team India, who were the dejected teams after they were the favorite to win the 87 World Cup. This was the first major tournament was coming after the 1987 World Cup, when all the teams were in this very ground in Calcutta and they were for the big tournament. So Nehru Cup was played, and when Nehru Cup was played, Pakistan made it to the grand finale versus the Viv Richards West Indies. At the one time, average was gone up to the 8. So what a thrilling victory we still remember against the West Indies, chasing 274, and finally it came down to the last over. And in the last over, we remember that three runs needed of 2 balls, Wasim Akram was on the crease and Viv Richard was the bowler, was the part-time bowler who was taking the wickets, and he underrated Wasim Akram. Still I remember Viv says that he put the straight ball to the Wasim and he just deceived him that he will put in the off or the leg, but he didn't put any variety, and it was a flipper and a straight ball. And Wasim Akram says that soon he delivered. We've delivered the ball. He recognized ball is coming where there is no turn, and Wasim was ready for a six, huge six over the mid wicket, and Pakistan winning in that today's date about 30 years ago, the Nehru Cup on the Indian ground, Calcutta, where 109,000 spectators were ready to see Team Pakistan, Imran Khan lifting the Nehru Cup for Pakistan. Still a lot of news for you. I have to go to break, and when I will come back from the break, we will discuss the Pakistan's victory over New Zealand. And Pakistan, how Pakistan is excelling in this shortest format of T20. We will discuss all. To stay tuned to the news and to stay tuned to the Dr. Adnan and the Match Point, you can follow me on the Greatest Empire USA with the same name on the YouTube as well as on the Facebook. Keep watching Match Point. You are watching E Awaaz. I will be right back. Welcome back after the break. You are watching Match Point, and we are discussing the Pakistan's victory, how Pakistan is cherishing the victory against the Kiwis and the Black Caps with a successive 11th series win in this format. This so far, which is the longest sequel by any team in the history of cricket in this format. The very first match, the T20 match, there was a three-match series in Pakistan was playing with New Zealand in the first match, and Pakistan winning it by 2 runs. Hafiz and Sarfraz shined with a bat, and Hafiz in a terrific form, making the 45. Hafiz couldn't complete his 50 and unfortunately got out on 45. Sarfraz making a good stand in the middle and then making the brisk 34 and then 148 for 6 wickets and then 2 wickets for Milne he got, and in reply, Munro and Taylor were the men to chase the Pakistan's target. But the brilliant bowling by Pakistan, Munro was unable to continue that effort. Munro, after making the half century, got out on 58. He was trapped. Taylor got out on 42. 3 wickets for Hasan Ali, and the New Zealand dream to break the sequel could not complete, and New Zealand losing the first game. Mohammad Hafiz, in the last 5 innings, what Hafiz is playing. Hafiz is playing superbly. He is the master of playing in the Pakistan and on the subcontinent pitches. Obviously, he is struggling when he is going away from the subcontinent. Whenever in the South Africa or in the English conditions or in the Australian conditions, as rest of the Asians, all the batsmen are struggling. Apart from the greats like Virat Kohli, who are having the batting practice around the world, as just like same as a subcontinent, Hafiz was having a little tough time. But when it comes to the pitches in UAE, Dubai, Abu Dhabi and Sharjah, the Pakistan's alternate home, he was the man to watch from Pakistan. Brilliant effort from Hafiz. 34 not out, 45, 32 not out, 40, 39 and 45 for the last scores which Hafiz made. Total 190 runs he have scored from the 4 innings, last innings in the T20, with an average of 63.33. Strike rate 134.75 with 14 sixes and 9 fours. Hafiz has smashed around the boundary against the opposition to make Pakistan win in these last games. Second T20, now we will go. When the second T20 came, it was the New Zealand chance to block Pakistan to win the 11th consecutive series. So there was a chance that Pakistan, they could hold the Pakistan effort not to have the longest run, but Pakistan was too good to handle by the poor Black Caps. Pakistan winning this by 6 wickets, and this time Pakistan was chasing, but chase was dramatic. Munro earlier playing, he pushed on the 44 runs. Munro, we have seen in the great form in this T20, but all his effort and the Williamson effort couldn't help Kiwis maintain the series or to block Pakistan winning. Munro on the 44, Williamson on the 37, and at the end, a brisk run by the Corey Anderson, who's having the fastest 50 also once he made the 44. New Zealand need to add little more, I think, power to their hard hitting, because we have seen when Munro was playing and Williamson was playing, they were hitting the tremendous boundaries, but little bit boundaries were short. I think the courtesy of the short grounds like Adelaide and the short grounds Hagley Oval in the New Zealand, as you, if you remember the 1992 semi-final, when on the leg side, Muin Khan was smashing the sixes, and some of the commentators were saying that those sixes will be six on any ground. So this is the problem, why Great Match was putting the sixes, huge sixes on that ground throughout the 1992 World Cup. He was in the great form because of the shorter ground. But when you come to the Asia, coming to the India, Dubai, Abu Dhabi, especially Dubai and Sharjah, and then to the Lahore Qaddafi Stadium, they're real long grounds, 82 to 85 meter boundaries, just like the Melbourne. So it's real hard to cross the boundary. So I think this, they were lacking the this smashing power. Both we have seen, the Munro as well as the Corey Anderson, as well as Williamson, the team captain. Colin Munro has been never dismissed by the left arm spinner in the T20s. And while the other hand, he was scoring 153 at the strike rate of 188.8 by the courtesy of 14 sixes in these innings. On the other hand, Imad Wasim's bowling average was 34.66 versus left-handers. So it was a huge contest between Munro and Imad Wasim. And I think in this, Imad Wasim couldn't perish him, but he was surviving against Imad, and he really, Munro, he played really well. A brilliant battle between these two. And then the three wickets at the end for Shaheen Afridi. Shaheen Afridi's spell of 3 for 20 is the best bowling figures by a under 19 fast bowlers in the T20. And the highlights of the Pakistan innings, Fakhar opening and the brisk 24, and then the Babar Azam man in form having the 240s from the Pakistan side. First Babar Azam making the 40, and then almost nearly 40, he was out on 38, Asif Ali, and Hafiz making again 34, and lot of contribution, teamwork from the Pakistan. Two wickets for the Milne again. Milne was the man who was picking the Pakistani, who was the pick of the New Zealanders in all the Pakistan T20. Seventh straight win for the Pakistan in the second T20. And this was the third time that they have won seven in a row. This is the only other team to do it on the three occasions. The previous team which has done this, seven victories in a row on the three occasions, was the Team India, Dhoni's team at that time. And now Pakistan has equalized the record. And soon I will tell you when the game will reach to the third T20, where Pakistan have won already the one series. Pakistan have now broken the India's record with the eighth win now. So India is on the second now. Pakistan is the best in every format in the T20s. Babar Azam, now I want to tell you that I told you that he was making 40, and the part of the T20 victories, Hafiz and he were doing batting and punishing the opposition from the top of the line. So this is what, jab main kehta hoon ki jung jo hai wo upar se ladi jati hai, Babar Azam, if Pakistan need the victory, Karachi Kings need the victory, Babar Azam will have to perform. If Babar will not perform, Karachi Kings or Pakistan cannot win the game. Babar Azam, last 8 innings if I go, 79, 40, 750, 45, 68, not out, 51, and then 97 not out. Unlucky he was, 437 runs he gathered with an average of 72.83 with a 550s and a strike rate of 126.67. And the fastest to get, now I want to tell you, the 1000 T20 runs, Babar Azam comes on the top of the list. Babar Azam now 26, while beating Virat Kohli at 27 innings. With a one match now, Babar has beaten Virat Kohli's excellency, and he is the fastest man in the 26 innings to reach the fastest 1000 runs in the T20 international. Fastest in terms of time since making the debut also goes to the Babar with a 2 years and 2 months. Second youngest 24 years to reach the milestone after his cousin Umar Akmal reached that milestone in 23 years. So with a 1 year, Umar Akmal has beaten Babar Azam, but Babar is still the best in this. Pakistan's bowling strength in the T20, it was absolutely brilliant. took taking 8 wickets for only 23 runs when Williamson was putting them under pressure, and we were thinking that one time that might be the game go away from them, and then soon Williamson got out and New Zealanders then went like the autumn leaves, just like they were with a blow of simple wind of the Pakistan bowlers. New Zealand was flying here and there, and they were never anywhere in the business. So Pakistan lost 11 T20s if I go while chasing with Sarfaraz Ahmed as a captain. Wow, 11 victories while chasing. Who says that Pakistan is the worst chaser? Who says that the Pakistani batsmen come under pressure? So this is a new record of 11 consecutive chases under the captaincy of Sarfaraz Ahmed. Most consecutive wins in the T20 while chasing. Pakistan 11-0 since 2016, when the one match series was played in the Manchester, when Muin Ahmed was put back in the English team, and Pakistan with the Old Trafford Manchester beating them. Since then, the Sarfaraz took over the captaincy. Pakistan winning ratio is now 11 this sequel. England is on the number 2 spot with the 8 victories from 2010 to 2011, and Australia on the 3rd spot with 8 consecutive wins from 2016 to 2018, and India with 7 victories under Mahendra Singh Dhoni from 2012 to 2014. So we quickly will go to the 3rd T20, where Pakistan winning the match and finally already won series by stretching their sequel and winning by 47 runs, batting first and making brilliant 163. It was very tough for the poor New Zealanders to chase 163 against the mighty pace of Pakistan in their alternate home. Babar Azam once again on the top, 79, Hafiz 53, and later on quick 19 by Malik. 2 wickets for the grand home, who did debut against Pakistan in the last year. Phillips then doing 26, and Williamson putting brilliant 60 runs, but it was too late for the Kiwis. Ish Sudhi made 11, and else than that, whole New Zealander team, whole of the Kiwis, none of them could go to the double figures in this match. 3 wickets for Shadab Khan and 2 each for Imad and the youngster Maqsood, who was playing the birthday game. He was given the cap on the birthday. Still to go the killer factor. Stay tuned to the match point. Shadab Khan finally finishes 2018 with 28 wickets, which is most by any Pakistan bowler in a one calendar year. And he equals the most by Jasprit Bumrah, who also took 28 wickets back in 2016. So the world's best record in the calendar year now goes jointly by the Jasprit Bumrah in 2016 and now by Shadab Khan in 2018. Most wickets in the T20 so far in the 2018. Shadab Khan on the top with 28, AJ Tai in the 27, Stanley 23, and Rashid Khan, the spin wizard from Afghanistan, on 22. And if we go to the most wickets in a calendar year in T20 history, Shadab Khan again 28, 2018 Jasprit Bumrah 28, but in the 2016 and in the 3rd Derek Nannies 27 wickets in 2010, and Andrew Tai 27 wickets in 2018. Saeed Ajmal, when he was at the peak, he got 25 wickets back in 2012. So 9th consecutive win for Pakistan in the T20s, breaking the India's record and their so far the longest winning streak in the format. Pakistan last 23 T20s, if I go, Pakistan have lost only 2 games and winning 21 games. Would you believe, Pakistan in the last couple of years in the T20, world record of 11 series wins in a row, world record of 11 wins in a row while chasing, and world record of 11 wins in a row while chasing, national record of 8 consecutive wins in T20. 11th consecutive series win in the T20 is a world record, and 16 wins in a 1 year calendar year is also a world record. Wow! And something more, 11 consecutive series win in the T20 while chasing is also a new world record. Pakistan team, no doubt the number one team of the T20 and the brilliant team of the T20. So for the 3rd match, T20 International, Babar Azam remained the man of the match, and for the man of the series at the end of the series, there was a close tie and the close finish for the Babar Azam as well as for the Hafiz for the most run getters, and both were going to the neck and neck to neck. And but as I told you, Hafiz is best in the business when it comes to the subcontinental pitches. So the final man of the series went to Mohammad Hafiz. Take a bow and we will take a short break, and when I will come back, we will discuss what our neighbors are doing, what Virat Kohli is doing and the other Indians are doing, and what Bangladesh is doing against Team Zimbabwe. And where is Skandar Azhar nowadays? We will see when, since he came to the set of the match points, we will see what is the fate of Skandar Azhar. Is he back to the Zimbabwean team, or yet he is not with the Zimbabwean team? You are watching Match Point. I'm Dr. Adnan. Keep tuned on the Greatest Empire USA Facebook page and the YouTube page, and you are tuning in right now on the E-Awaz TV. I will be right back. Welcome back on the Match Point. So at the end, we will go towards the neighbors, as I promised you. So what Team India is doing? So before going to the Team India, as we were discussing previously in our show about the Team Pakistan, who is number one in the T20 and is going on with the amazing shining colors. But who is the other one who is number one in the business? Who is the other one who is tremendously good in this business? The one man show by for the whom I say that if he would have been given a chance to play in the desert, he will score on the desert. If he would have been given a chance to play on the mountains, he will score on the mountains. If he would have been given a chance to play on any kind of grass, on the tennis court, he will score over there. Number one batsman, super duper Indian skipper, Virat Kohli. Virat Kohli is not with the Indian team. Virat ji kahan hai? Virat ji is not with the Indian team because he is having a heart. And when he is having a heart, we can show you in these pics where Virat is having a Kadwa Chauth functions along with his darling Anushka Sharma. And now you can see what Virat Kohli is doing. Ji, ye dekhiye the pics of Diwali, how Kohli is going to the Diwali, and he is absolutely enjoying the Indian functions and the traditional functions. And before turning 30, if I go, Virat Kohli smashed total number of 38 centuries before turning to the age of 30 years. Would you believe? This is most by any batsman in the history of international cricket. The most centuries in the ODI before turning 30, Virat Kohli on the 208 innings and 38 centuries. Second number, you can see Sachin Tendulkar with 34 centuries, but just check his number of matches, 305, while Chris Gayle with 19 centuries and 200 innings, Saurav Ganguly with 192 innings and 18 centuries, and then down the list, AB de Villiers 153 innings and 16 centuries, and then Ricky Ponting 204 in 15 centuries and 204 innings. So a double triple congratulations for Virat Kohli, and happy times. He is not with the Indian team, but with a famous Indian traditions, as I told you, first Kadwa Chauth, then Diwali, and now happy birthday to the Virat Kohli, the number one batsman of the cricket. And now we will show you a short glimpse what Team India is doing on Diwali. So let's talk about Zimbabwe versus Bangladesh, where Bangladesh was the giant and the king, and the poor Zimbabwean who were on the tour, and the match was being played in the Sylhet, in the home of Bangladesh. But the poor Bengalis were once again beaten against the traditions, and this time not by the team Pakistan, not by the team India, not by the team England or team South Africa or Australia. This time they were beaten by the Zimbabwean team. So hats off to the Zimbabwean team. Absolute joyous moment for them, joyful moment for them. A much awaited victory for Zimbabwe, and they beat Bangladesh in their den convincingly by 151 runs. Wow. And Masek Kratza brilliantly performing from the top in both innings, and Williamson and Moore shining with the bat, and Sikandar Raza finally wrapping Bangladesh in the Sylhet in their home with 6 wickets. And last time when Sikandar came to my show, and I asked Sikandar that when he will be the part of the Zimbabwean team when he was up on the tour of the North America, and he was eager. He's a die-hard Zimbabwean fan, and he's a die-hard Zimbabwe patriot cricketer, and he told that he's eager to play. Soon the board clears the situation and they are all willing to play for Zimbabwe, and just see, they did it. They performed for the team Zimbabwe, and Sikandar Raza shining with the ball, taking the crucial 6 wickets, 3-3 in both innings, and wrapping the match for Zimbabwe. And this was the much needed victory for Zimbabwe. And so the 2 or 3 men who came to the show, Sikandar Raza, Ben McDermott, and then shining back to their team with the flying colors, Ben got the Aussies cap, the green baggy cap from the Australia, and Sikandar Raza shining with his brilliant performance. We are very happy and we congratulate Sikandar Raza for this shining performance. And Zimbabwe, who was first away test victory in the 17 years. That's why I say a much awaited victory. Remember, this Bangladesh team have won a test against England and Australia. This is not that weak team. They have beaten previously England, also beaten Australia convincingly, and this time they were against the Minnows. But then Zimbabwe retaliated, and retaliated very well. Bangladesh have now gone 8th consecutive innings in the test without reaching 200. What a poor way for the Bangladesh. It is the worst 200 less streak by an established test team in the last 122 years in the history of cricket. Yes, that is ignoring Bangladesh's own streak of 12 innings which they have made without making 200 in the early years when they were giving the test status after beating Team Pakistan in the 1999 last match of the Super 6 in the World Cup finals in the 1999. When in the Super 6 stage, Pakistan lost to them, and before the Super 6, Pakistan lost to them, and Wasim Akram saying, "We lost to our brothers," and then the test status was awarded to them, and that was the worst sequel of their own for not making 200 in the test matches. And now Bangladesh have broken their own previous sequel of 1999 and 2000, and now this is the new worst sequel and unwanted record for Bangladesh. No other team has played 8 innings without reaching 200 in the last 122 years. So Bangladesh is the only team who have crossed this stage in the last 122 years and yet not to make the 200 score for their test team. Bangladesh got all out on 143 and they have gone past 150 only once in the last 8 innings. So the batting coach really needs to see the batting woes for Bangladesh, that what's happening in Bangladesh. Zimbabwe's 151 runs victory over Bangladesh is their first test victory since September 2013. It is also their first test victory away from the home since November 2001, when Neil Johnson and Heath Streak shining for the team Zimbabwe in those glorious days, and the best run for the Zimbabwe in those days. Australia, now we will discuss something about the previous number one team. After the Zimbabwe's victory, the Bangladesh poor run, the India team shining against West Indies, and Pakistan shining against Australia and New Zealand. Now Australia, which I say usually the best team of the world, the best challenging team, always when Pakistan is playing any other team, I'm always afraid that the team which bounces back the most dangerous team in Australia. You can never underestimate these Aussies. When these green baggy caps are on their day, they are so revenging. They are so revenging that it's an unstoppable run. They never admit the defeat. They have the hunger of runs. They have the hunger of wickets, whether going to the any format of the cricket. But to the very surprisingly, the team which has won the most World Cup titles in the history of the game, which is the champions of the champions, I want to remind you what's happening with Team Australia. Australia's last five T20s, they have lost four. Only they have won the one game that was against the Minnows, UAE, right now back in the last month. Australia's, if I go to the last 12 ODIs, they have lost 11 games. Can you believe? And they have won only one game. If I go now to the test matches, Australia last five tests, they have lost four test matches and they have been able to draw only one game, that was against Pakistan recently. If Pakistan would have been able to bowl out them in the first test match being played in the Dubai Abu Dhabi, so this would have been the 5-0 slate black wash or whitewash, whatever you say, with the Team Australia. So really pitiful condition for the Team Australia right now, after the Warner went out, Smith went out, and the new saga and a lot of new players in the team, Aaron Finch taking the command. So things are not really getting well for the Team Australia, so a lot of worries for the team coach. Let's come back. Before I fold the show, I need to tell you something what Pakistan has achieved, some of the records which we couldn't discuss in the before the first break. I want to discuss that what Pakistan have done in the T20 internationals against New Zealand. Since the last World Cup T20, Pakistan have won 29 out of 33 T20s, so win percentage of 87.88, the highest percentage of win and victory for any team which Pakistan has performed. The most economical team in the last 2 years, Pakistan have bowled 536.4 overs with an economy rate of 7, which is lowest by the any full member team. Pakistan bowlers have bowled 10 maiden overs in that period, which is twice more than Australia and Bangladesh, who have bowled 5 scoreless overs each. Babar Azam, which is the new Pakistan runs machine and the most run getter, who is going neck to neck with the legendary Virat Kohli and the Pakistani Viv Richard and the Pakistani Virat Kohli. Babar Azam making a world record is one thing doing, but surpassing Virat Kohli is now an extraordinary achievement, and he has done it in 26 games, while Virat has done in the 27 games, fastest to get the 1,000 runs. Babar Azam during the course of 79 against the Black Caps in the third T20 in Dubai, he became the quickest to score 1,000, again I tell you, in the cricketing history in the T20. He needed only 26 innings and he did it in style and breaking Virat Kohli's record. Babar, who did a debut in the Manchester, the match I was discussing with you under the captaincy of great Misbahul Haq when Pakistan was there, the one-off T20 in the Old Trafford, Manchester, from where the winning sequel of Sarfraz Ahmed has started. He is also the quickest to score 1,000 runs in terms of time, taking less than 2 years and 2 months to accomplish this. The previous quickest in the terms of days was England, Alex Hales, having done it at the age of 24 years and 20 days. Babar is the second youngest to get the 1,000 runs, only behind his cousin Umar Akmal, who was 23 when he accumulated 1,000 runs. Babar Azam with 1,031 runs at 54.26 average is the only batsman in the T20 history with an average maintaining and keeping above 50.01. The specialist in bowling out opponents, Pakistan bowling machine, for which Pakistan is boasting over the decades with the great WOs and then the Shoaib Akhtar and lot others, Pakistan have bowled out opponents in the 31 occasions in the T20s. It is the 12 more than the next best, Australia and New Zealand, who have done it 19 times each. Surprisingly, 8 out of 31 instances, have come out in 2018 and three in the last six games against Australia and New Zealand. So now in the end, discussing about the defenders giving Pakistan bowlers the 150 runs to play with, and 93 out of 100 times they will win out a game for you. Take a bowl. Whether it's an era of Imran Khan, whether it's an era of Waseem Akram, whether it's an era of Waqar Yunus, whether it's an era of Shoaib Akhtar or Abdul Razak, Pakistan bowlers have always did it for their batsmen. They ask them, only give us 100 runs or 150 on the board and we will do it. And we will perish the batting opposition into the hell. 93 out of 100 times they win the game for Pakistan. In the entire history of T20 cricket, Pakistan have lost only 3 out of 45 matches when Pakistan was defending 145 target. This is the strength where Pakistan is boasting over the decades. Next, Pakistan have to play now the ODI versus Kiwis. So here is some tough part and scintillating part might be not for good for the Pakistani viewers, that Pakistan last 11 completed ODIs against New Zealand, they are all lost. So Pakistan really needs a morale boosting victory. And if New Zealand beats Pakistan in all the games or the at least three games of the ODIs, New Zealand will surpass the Pakistan's worst record against South Africa, and South Africa is the worst stretching sequel of losing games in the 90s when Pakistan was losing deliberately again and again versus South Africa. If New Zealand wins three games, they will beat South Africa's record, and this will be the Pakistan's new worst sequel. And when South Africa made the sequel, they broke the worst Pakistan sequel against the Viv Richards West Indies. That was for the 10 games at that time back in the 89 and 92. And later on, at the end of the 90s, South Africa is making the record against Pakistan. And now Kiwis are really will be in a hunt of making a new record. So it's a time to wrap up the show, as I have got the signal from my team that this is the end of the match point. But before we go to the end, what we do, bring the music on, Killer Factor. So there is a killer factor for you. Waqas, who was given a cap, T20 cap, a green cap for the Pakistan. What a shining moment for a youngster. He was given the cap by the great legendary Azhar Mahmood, the bowling coach of Pakistan. Waqas was given the cap on his birthday. So this is a new record. Ultimately, Waqas taking the two wickets on the birthday on his debut. This is also a new world record. But this is not the end of the killer factor. Waqas is the only player in the history of T20 cricket who made the debut on his birthday. None other in the history of cricket has made the debut on his birthday in T20s. But still music is on, because this is not the end of the killer factor. There is one more batsman, also a bowler from Pakistan, Asif Mujtaba. If you remember the game in the 1986 against the Allen Border Australia, when he hit Steve Waugh on the last ball six and equalized the match of the World Series Cup for Pakistan against Australia in the home of Australia. Also got the cap on his birthday. But as I told that Waqas is the only one, that cap was given on the ODI. So that is the ODI cap. That is the only cap in the ODI which has been given on the birthday of the player, that was given to the Asif Mujtaba. So Asif Mujtaba and Waqas are the two different and the only bowlers in both formats, only batsmen or bowlers in both formats, cricketers who got the caps on their birthdays respectively in the T20s and in the ODIs. But this is also not the end of the killer factor. Here we go, the music is on. Both the players back in the 80s and now in 2018, nearly after 30 years, both were given the Pakistan shining cap on 4th of November. This is my killer factor. 4th of November is that majestic and magical date when Pakistan made a record to giving the cap to the birthday boys, and that consecutively happening on the same date but in the different years. So I hope you would have enjoyed the killer factor as well as the show. For the suggestions, you can see scrolling my phone numbers and also our Facebook page Greatest Empire USA and the YouTube page Greatest Empire USA, and I will be happy to have your reviews and what else you want to see in the show Match Point. And when I will come next time in the show, I will bring on the exciting ODI series of Pakistan versus New Zealand, and we will see that will Pakistan be able to survive and to break the losing sequel against the Kiwis. Hopefully Pakistan will avoid the certain defeat to avoid the longest sequel against New Zealand, and still fingers are crossed that Pakistan will be able to beat New Zealand or not. But for that, you will have to tune into the Match Point. Till then, Dr. Adnan says you goodbye. Take care and bye-bye. But Sarfraz doing the completing the job, and he was perished on 54. But it was too late for Sarfraz was 34 tha yaar, 54 nahi. हाँ, मैन ऑफ द मैच. ठीक है, इसमें कहूँ इसमें कहूँ? वो अजीब तो नहीं लग रही आखिर, मेरा ख्याल है कवर हो जाएगी. बस ठीक है, इससे आऊँ इससे आऊँ, शॉर्ट से आऊँ. या मेरा ख्याल है लॉन्ग से आके बाद में शॉर्ट पे आके बात कर खत्म करूँगा. जाऊँ champions of 1999. What a victory for the Sri Lankans. A fantastic effort.